bows down! I'll tear your limbs! Down! them!
Thank you.
attack! Attack! Give him hell! Attack! Give him hell! Attack! Cease shooting! Stop shooting! Attack! Fuse down! Give him hell! Stop shooting! Fuse down! Ah! Stop shooting! Stop shooting! Cease shooting! Thank you. Bows down! Stop shooting! moving! Onwards!
my god, guys, I'm so sorry. My mic is muted. I feel so stupid. Why is that happening? Oh, my mic's muted all the time. Oh my god, it's another one of these videos. Oh, for god's sake. I'm gonna go over what's happened in terms of scoring. So round one was the Britannians versus the Archers. That was, well, the high grade archers versus low grade archers. Imperials killed three peasants. Survived and killed three peasants, and two of them lived. Two of the peasants lived at the end. Sturgeons, exactly the same. Got up to three peasants, and then two peasants still lived at the end. The Azurai got to four peasants. All four peasants were alive at the end. Landian, four peasants. One was alive at the end. Britannian, six peasants. Three were alive at the end. Kuzates, two peasants, and one was alive at the end. For round two, that was for the melee, the Imperial recruits versus the. By the way, guys, I'm so sorry, my mic is muted. But yeah, that's for that one. Imperials, two peasants. Only one peasant survived. Sturgeons, three peasants. All three peasants survived. Azurai, four peasants. Three peasants survived, so they killed one. The Flandians got four peasants, four lived. Britannia got to five peasants, all five peasants lived, but I kind of had a feeling that they'd die around there. Kuzates got to two peasants, and both of the peasants lived. But basically, I've already said, by the way, because Flandia don't really have a proper archer unit for themselves, I am going to deduct this third round. This third round, they're not actually going to get any points for, because they don't actually have a legit, like an actual one for them. It's mainly just a mercenary, but I just threw it in there as like just to include it. I'm also going to, as a fourth round, I'm going to include like availability, how like common they are to find and how easy they are to recruit and level up. But I think Britannians will win this. I have a feeling they do. I'm going to have a little bonus thing at the end where basically it'll be like 100 Britannian Fian champions versus like a bunch of, what are they called? A bunch of I've lost my train of thought. Against a bunch of peasants, basically like 1,000 peasants or something. But let's see. So oh wow, that's a perfect number. Oh, I did say I said like obviously my mind wasn't on, but I did say they'd kill about 70. And that's about 70. 69 kills. I'm only running things once today because I'm planning on doing another stream after, so I'm gonna leave it at this for now. How many remained? 8 remained. Wait, what? They killed 69 and all 23 routed, so we'll do that. So we'll do 23 routed and then 8 lived. 8 enemies remain and 10 deaths. There we go. And then finally it's Kuzates. I've got like no hope for the Kuzates at this point. But yeah, I've also been working out the range of them. So I've worked out Imperials tend to begin shooting at about, tend to begin arrow, like launch, sending the arrows at around 135 range, sort of meters, I guess it is. Sturgeons are the same. Azurai is about 125. Flandians, I'm not counting because obviously I'm not counting them for this round because, well, they're not actually like Flandian specific troops, they're mercenary specific troops that you can't, that are hard to get. But the Britannian Fian champions, 147 range. So far, Britannians are just like, they've won, basically. The Britannians have won. We'll leave these guys to do this. I'm going to quickly turn my fan on because I'm roasting and I'm like stressing a bit because my voice wasn't in that like hour of gameplay. Now, because of that, I am going to do another stream after because that's bad. I was wondering why my views kept going up because people were joining and straight back down because I wasn't speaking, but oh well. But yeah, we're going to, we move. It is what it is. Things like that happen from time to time. I don't even know if it was muted. It was on Xbox, but it could have like come through on Twitch, but I don't know. I don't know if it would. I don't think it does, but yeah, I'm going to do another stream after this. I might do a Minecraft stream or something because I've been working on a house and stuff, so I might stream me adding a few things to it. But yeah, let's see what these guys get. I don't think these get very far, to be completely honest. I reckon they flop pretty soon. pretty fast. Let's see. What? How far are they? So the range isn't gonna be good, but that's also because there is like a mountain here. But it's the RNG factor. It is what it is. A lot of things have happened since the last. This is episode 16, by the way, of my Bannerlord campaign. Well, yeah, campaign game. A lot has happened. We've taken a lot of places and also lost quite a bit. A lot of wars and stuff aside. Same as Ark, or Arkstrom. I actually named a couple of Kangaroo and Zellers in the world, and I'm planning on doing it in Jordan when I find one, but I'll do that on the stream when I find it. These are actually doing better than I expected. Okay, they actually did good that round. Okay, never mind. So I'm not going to count their range because there's no point. So 45 kills. They got 55 enemies remain, and then 10 deaths, obviously 10 deaths. There we go. And now round four. This is I don't actually have to go into anything for this. I can literally just do it. I can do it in the you know what? I'm gonna put like 50 while I'm actually talking this through. Fiend champions, I'm gonna do that, and we're gonna do like 50 of them, so I'm gonna have 51. We're gonna put them against 100, put them against 100 of the Triarii, I reckon. Well, 99 Triarii, technically. But yeah, so we're gonna do this. So I'm gonna back up a little bit. I'm gonna let them. We're actually gonna put them on loose as well. This isn't like going towards any point, so I'm just gonna do this how it is, because I'm literally just gonna talk through the fourth round. The fourth round is basically gonna be based on availability on the map. So Imperials, Sturgeons. Who's next? Azurai. Then there's Vlandia, but they're like non-existent. Britannia, and then finally Kuzates. Okay, so for this then, how it's gonna work is from my experience. So Imperials, thing is about Imperials, there are actually three Imperial kingdoms, so they are probably the most common. So I am going to put them as most common and easiest to get, but again they're not the best, so they're probably not going to win this even with that. I'd say second from starting location. We'll do from starting location and then also in general at the same time. Starting location, Azurai probably second. I'm just going to put second. Then I'd say probably Kuze's third. I'd say Britannia 4, Sturgeon's 5th, and then Vlandia are crap, basically. But yeah, let's work out the winners, well, the scoreboard, or the, yeah, scoreboard. So, wait, scoreboard, there we go. So, in first place, so first we will have... let me tell you these points now then. So we've got, so for the first round, Britannians won, so there's 5 points for Britannians. Second round, Britannians won, that's 10 points in total for Britannians. Third round, Britannians won, 15 points in total. They got 4 in the fourth round, so that's 2 points, so 15, 17. So Britannia won with 17 points. Second, and we all knew Britannia was going to win, didn't we? By the way, guys, they're doing horrible against the Triarii. They're not doing terrible. yeah, they're not doing the best. Oh well. But let's work this out. Round one. So in round one, who did second best? Vlandia actually did the second best. So but they're not gonna get any points. They're not gonna be. Let me work this out. So Azurai. If I die, I die. It's fine. I don't know, man. Azurai got. So they got third. So that would be 3 points. They got 3 points there. Three. And then here they got. Second, so add 4, 7.
We won!
Round 3, they got 4th, so that's 2, so 9. And they got 2nd there, so 9 add 4. 13, they got 13 points, so I'm actually just going to write these down here. I'm not going to put them in just yet, because I want to figure out who got the most points in between them. Oh, actually, no, I am going to write them, but I'm going to... Azurai, I'll change them if they're not right. They got 13 points. If they're different, then if they're wrong, then I'll change them. But for now, I'll just do them like this. I reckon who would have been there? I think Imperial's second to last, and Kuze's the last. Let's tally up for Vlandia. Vlandia got second in that one, so that's 4 points. They got. Third there, yeah, they got third, so 4 at 3 is 1, mine's just gone, that's 7. round 3, we're not going to count that one, are we? So they got 7 so far. Round 4, they got 1, because they got last, so 8, they got 8 points. Vlandia, 8 points. So these aren't actually third, by the way, guys, in the entire thing. I'm just sort of working them out first, and then I'll sort it out after. Right, so they won, obviously. But yeah, so let's work out Sturgia now, because I think they got easily third or fourth. Sturgia, so 3 peasants, 2 lived, so they definitely got third. So that's... Wait, did they? No, they got fourth. There's six factions. Oh crap! Oh yeah, that makes sense. The last one doesn't get any points. So I actually know that Vlandia's got 7 points. They actually got 7 points. Oh, not good for Vlandia. I cannot lie. Obviously this isn't actually right just yet, guys. And as I said, I'm just gonna work it out first. So what did I say? So what did they get? They got 4. So that's 2 points. Yeah, 4th is 2 points, 3rd is 1, no, 5th is 1, and then 6th is 0, so they got 2 points, and then 2nd round, what did they place? They placed 1, 2, they placed 4th again, so that's 4 points, not looking good for Sturgia. 4th, and then they placed 1, 2, they placed 5th, so that's 5 points, wow, they're done out here. 5, and then they got 5th again, so that's 1 more point. They literally got 6 points. Oh, that's, yeah. 6 points. They got less than Vlandia, to be fair. 5th, I think. I don't come up with math. We'll do Imperial next. Imperial. Vlandia didn't even. I missed one of Vlandia's rounds off, and they still like being Sturgia. Imperial, actually we might already have them in order now, okay. Imperial, I think they got 5th. Yeah, they got 5th. Ooh, no, they got joint 4th. So that's 2 points. Round 2, they got 5th, so that's 3. Round 3, they actually got 3rd. Yeah, they got 3rd, so... 3 points, so what was it, 6 points in total? They've actually beat the Sturgeons. And 5 points for that, because they're the most common in round 4, so they're actually fine, so that bumps them up. So what did I say? So it was 6, so they're on 11. Actually, ooh, wow. So they're actually 3rd. The 6, so I'm going to have to move up and down. Actually, just give this count, I can just go. Change this to 4th. Go down, no. Down, then press this one like that, and then this can be 5th, like that, and then Imperials can go third. Third Imperial, they got 11 points, and then Kuzey's the sixth, obviously. Kuzey, considering the Vlandians don't actually have like a dedicated archer group, they've done pretty well. They got fourth, which isn't bad. This is sick, obviously. Oh, it's not letting me do it. One sec. Oh my god, why is it this being that? Sixth place, obviously, Kuzates. Let's see how many points they got. Not many. They might have actually. No, they haven't won. They got last there, so that's. Well, they got fifth technically, so that's 1 point. They got last there, so that's zero. They got 1 point. They got second there, so that's four. They got 5 points in total right now. They got third, so that's three. They got 8 points. Ooh, they have actually beat the Vlandians and the Sturgeons. Fourth, Kuzates, 8 points. There we go. So then, this I'll tell you how the scores are in a second, guys. Just give me a quick moment to sort out the score. Scoreboards. Sixth. There we go. Okay, so this is how it looks. Batania is first. I think we all guessed that with 17 points. Second in place is Azurai with 13 points. So Batania and Fian Archers, Fian Champions even. Azurai Master Archers, Imperial Palatine Guards, I think they're called, come third with 11 points. The Kuzey Heavy Archers, something. The highest tier archers, they come in fourth place with 8 points. Fifth place we have the Vlandian ones. I forgot what they're called now. They're not actually, they're these, the Arboreals. They're a mercenary one, but we counted them. That's why I took one round away, because I thought maybe they'd get pushed down to like sixth, but they actually got fifth. They got 7 points. And sixth place, the loser of today, was Sturgeon Heavy. Oh wait, sorry, the Kuzey one was the marksman. It was this one, Sturgeon Veteran Bowman. With 6 points, they got sixth place, which is pretty fitting. But yeah, basically, Batania smoked everyone. But yeah, that was, I'd say that was good. That was fun. I enjoyed that. I feel like I knew that was gonna happen. I had a feeling Batania would win. I had a feeling that Azurai would come second. I had a feeling Imperial would come third. The other three was a toss up. I thought Vlandia would come last, but they did enough in the other three rounds that they were part of to actually get, like, just edge the victory. But I thought Sturgia would have been above Kuzey's, because obviously Kuzey's a horse archer, so they do still technically specialise in archery. But what we're going to do now is, guys, we're going to do something very fun. As the little bonus at the end of the episode that I like to do every so often, we're actually going to do 300, because we'll do 1,000. We'll do a long 1,000 battle. We'll do it's going to be 1,000 peasants versus, well, 100 Britannian Fian champions. I'll have to put 101 because I'm the 101. There we go. And yeah, we're going to fight on. We'll fight on the step. Why not? But yeah, let's get them ready. Hopefully we're on the hill, because that would make the fight a bit more fun. We're not. Oh, we're actually at the base of a hill. Not bad. Put them there. Spread out. Spread them legs. We'll put them like there, like that. Yeah, looks good. Then I'll come like. I'll just run behind them in it. Cause they're like 410 meters away. But yeah, these guys are most likely gonna win. The balance of power is like massively in our. Well, it's just in our favor by a bit. But, I see them winning. So 101 versus 399 isn't bad. So we've probably got about three or four waves of them coming in. But hopefully, if we can hold this group off, the next group will just get picked up at. And then they'll start retreating eventually as well. But, yeah, let's figure this out. I actually want to see. I want to see if they can hold, because I know they used to be able to hold their own. They used to be able to beat 1,000 peasants, but With the recent patches, they might have been nerfed. I'm not 100%. I don't really look at the patches that much. See what the range is as well. It's 210. Well, 197. What did I have? I think I have 170 something. There we go. 175. Yeah, about 173. 17. About 173. Around there. And then as they get closer, more and more, I'm just gonna start firing. Watch them kills just slowly climb. Watch them deaths just slowly climb on the peasant's bar. Yeah, look at them. They have these times where it's like slow, and then as soon as they get close, it's just rapid. It just shoots up. Look at that, it's already 100 and... yeah. Yeah, done. Are they retreating? No, they're spreading out, so actually it's trying to envelop them. Most of their guys have spawned back there, though. There's not many here, and even if there was, they're just going to get... well, no, the ones that are here now are just going to get picked apart when they actually get into melee combat. Yeah, look, they're just going to slice them with the melee armor and win that way. So far, there's zero deaths or wounded on our side, and 377 on theirs. Their second wave's coming. There's 220 in the second wave. Well, 200 and then 199, and then that little group there, which I'm guessing is about 21. Not bad, but I reckon they hold. I reckon we hold. I genuinely think these guys will hold. This is why I say Battalion Fiend champions are sick in this game. They are actually awesome. But it's very hard to get through a Battalion Fiend champion army. Right now, I don't have a Battalion Fiend champion army. I only have about 17 Battalion Fiend champions because all of mine are like low level ones. So they don't level up very fast at all times. But yeah, look, just look at it. It speaks for itself. Look, we're almost on 400 already. It's been 3 minutes of the battle. Like, the enemy line slightly touched us, the last one. But they all got killed. We've not had a single wounded, single death. They're still firing. I don't know how much ammo they'll have left. Their reinforcements have just come. These guys are going to get picked apart bit by bit, and then by the time they actually hit the line, there'll be such like a small little detachment of them that they're just going to get absolutely wiped out. Look, a lot of them are actually retreating. They go 550 already. That's what I mean, they're stupid little bit. They're not even going to reach the line this time. They'll die before they even reach the line. The ones retreating are like, are getting shot. We kind of need to hold the fire now because we need to save it for that group. We've already killed half of them, over half. And it's been like, their line has only touched us once, and it was like a couple guys, it wasn't even many. And my guys, it didn't even touch the line actually, these guys ran out of the side. It might have touched on the other side, but there was like three enemies there, so it didn't really matter. But yeah, you see what I mean? They are stupidly strong. I don't know when they're going to run out of arrows though. He's actually been hit, I think. But they will run out of arrows soon, and all I have to do really is move them up a little bit, and they'll go pick arrows up off dead bodies and off the ground and stuff. There we go. Yep, look at them one bit by bit, they're just going to get annihilated. They go up 600, they've just got another wave in. I reckon I'm going to let these guys kill this wave off, and then when these are the majority gone, I'm going to send them up to grab a few arrows. So far so good, they are holding, they're holding very well. Doing a very good job. I'm gonna push them off a bit because I'm gonna give them a chance to gather arrows and stuff, and then I'll send them back. Watching them gather arrows is actually pretty sick because they literally just walk up to them. Look. It's like a little foraging party, they just run around when they need the arrows. And watch, you just see them all start running around and stuff, and what we'll do is we'll hold fire. They'll still go around collecting the arrows. What we'll do is, about here, send them back. Give them do out. Fire at will. Perfectly don't fire just yet though.
Onward! Forward! Get move! Move out! Move! Forward! Get move! Onward! Move out! Move! Onward!
But yeah, having an archer on the army is actually pretty sick. You'd think it'd be a liability because obviously they can't move as fast as, let's say, cavalry and obviously the archer, so you'd think they're a bit weaker in terms of melee, but Italian Fian champions are not to be played with in melee or at range. That's the thing with them. They're sick. They're actually just sick. I don't know how they're so good. They are, they're just amazing. But look, I think it's the last one. I'd probably even be comfortable charging them, but I don't want to just in case they absolutely get smashed and then just killed the entire army. But yeah, look, this is what I mean. There's certain troops, especially for defense.
Give them hell!
If you looked at these would be good on defense. If you had an army of these, like let's say 100 of these behind 100 sturgeon, about 25 sturgeon heavy spearmen and like 75 heavy axemen, and you're literally not losing. You can't. Whether the enemy have cav or not, really, because the sturgeon heavy spearmen hold them off, while these guys kill everything else, and the axemen help with infantry and whatnot. Yeah, as you can see though, guys, they won. They won decisively. But yeah, with that, guys, they didn't even lose a single guy either. But yeah, with that, guys, if you enjoyed, make sure to like, comment, share, and follow on Twitch. Subscribe on YouTube if you haven't already. I'm going to try and get back to the regular daily uploads. That's until my next assignment's due in. And then I'll be gone for a little bit again, I think. But apologies in advance. I hope you all have a great day. Hope you all do choose to subscribe and join the group. Well, join the growing community that I'm trying to build. And I hope to see you again. Hope you all have a great day, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye for now, guys.